House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy is asking Speaker Nancy Pelosi to suspend the House impeachment inquiry into the president until she establishes more, quote, transparent and equitable rules and procedures. In his letter to Pelosi, McCarthy goes on to write, "The swiftness and recklessness with which you have proceeded has already resulted in committee chairs attempting to limit minority participation in scheduled interviews, calling into question the integrity of such an inquiry." Joining me now to offer his analysis is Christopher Bedford, editor-in-chief of The Daily Caller and the author of The Art of the Donald. Chris, welcome back to the program.
Thank you.
The House Minority Leader, Kevin McCarthy, calling for the impeachment inquiry to be suspended as a result of what he's been saying. What's your reaction to all of what he's been saying, first off? And then, do you agree with him that things are moving way too fast?
Well, I think it's rushed, and there's a reason that it's rushed. It's because the Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi, didn't want this impeachment inquiry to go forward. She's one of the few Democrats in the House who seems to think that they could actually win this upcoming election, and that's what Democrats ought to be focused on. But it seems, and by all accounts I've heard from the Hill, that she may have lost control of her caucus. It's gotten too much, and they finally found something that was foreign entanglement that they could bring up again and push for impeachment, so she had to just let the floodgates open. But we knew since before, I mean, as soon as President Trump was the nominee, Democrats were calling for him to be impeached if he became president. So this game plan has been a long time coming, and Republicans are going to fight it every step of the way, just like Democrats fought it every step of the way when Bill Clinton was impeached.
The impeachment inquiry at this point seems to have a narrow focus. I mean, it's about President Trump's conversation with the president of Ukraine and his request to investigate former Vice President Joe Biden and his son Hunter. Does this narrow focus stemming from a whistleblower complaint really make it more or less likely that this inquiry is actually going to move forward?
I mean, it will move forward through the House of Representatives based simply on partisanship. I could not possibly tell you how talking to the head of Ukraine about Joe Biden's conspiracy in Ukraine is somehow a high crime or a misdemeanor, which would be one of the things outside of treason that is an impeachable offense. The Democrats are going to have to make that case to the American people, and it's a difficult one to make because it's foreign policy in a country that most people who haven't played the game Risk have never really heard of that much. But it does fit in with the Democrats' larger push of foreign entanglement with Russia, and it fits in with that general region of the world. So the groundwork has been laid. Most of this is going to be fought in public relations. I guarantee it'll pass the House, and what happens after that is up to Mitch McConnell.
You've studied the president. You know he's been on the offensive, going after Democrats, the whistleblower, the media. What are your thoughts about his strategy now, especially in light of the fact that he's been accused of abuse of power?
Well, yesterday was the first time during his press conference I've ever seen the president lose his temper. He's been angry before, but I think he lost his temper. He's an absolute expert at controlling what the media is speaking about and changing the subject and throwing wild cards and basically tricking a lot of reporters. But this time, impeachment seems to be the number one thing. Everyone from the cold, calculating minds at NPR to the more frantic minds at CNN are going nuts, and the Democrats are all about it. So the president is going to have to focus on that. And China, he's pushing it out into the open. He's saying, like he said before, China, Australia, Ukraine. But it's going to give ammunition to his enemies because China is an enemy country, although everyone knows, as President Trump has always said, China is an enemy of his.
Looking ahead now, President Trump travels today to Florida, where he's speaking about Medicare in front of a Republican-friendly audience. How significant is today's trip in changing the focus for voters?
I think it's only significant in changing his own focus, which is important. Mm-hmm. When you're completely besieged in your mansion in Washington, surrounded by Republicans who may be looking for orders and Democrats who are on the attack and a very hostile media, it can be difficult, and it's a total siege mentality. To go down to a sprawling outdoor village in Florida that's a Republican stopover filled with friendly faces to talk about your policy, that's the kind of important thing that he might need, maybe with some golfing. But it's certainly not going to move the ball for any of the people who have been trying to impeach this president since he came in, and that's going to continue to be the story.
So many interesting aspects of this story. Christopher Bedford, editor-in-chief of The Daily Caller and the author of The Art of the Donald. Thanks so much for your analysis.
Thank you.